And because for the first time, I was thinking of Apple Notes in a different way. I've used Apple Notes, I think, since it came out. But basically, it was a stack of notes, a pile of notes, you know, like individual notes.
So before we begin, Matthias, let's talk about Forever Notes. I'm obviously very jealous you came up with it. I came up with the Benta methodology, but this is so much cooler because you can just grab Apple Notes and use it straight away. Can you take us through how you came up with the idea and a little bit more about it?
I think we share a common background trying to be better at productivity and trying to have the right tools and trying out new things that are constantly coming up. And so I have my share of that experience, and I've used Notion and I've used Obsidian. I tried them, and I think they're fantastic tools. What my struggle with them was that even though they're super adaptable to your own needs, very often they seem like an overkill for my needs. I think they're great tools, and I think there are many use cases where people use these tools, and it makes a lot of sense. What I was looking for was something simpler, and still I wanted to build it my way. So I wanted that that freedom of building it my way. With the introduction of linking in Apple Notes, to me, this opened up a whole new world. And because for the first time, I was thinking of Apple Notes in a different way. I've used Apple Notes, I think, since it came out, but basically it was a pile of notes, you know, like individual notes. And with linking, all of a sudden, I was able to put structure in it. You know, folders was, you know, I mean, were there, and I used those, and of course, nested folders and all of those things. With links, it really changed the way I looked at the app. And then I think the first thing that I did was sort of a page, you know, like a dashboard where, you know, I linked sort of the most important notes that I would be using all the time. And then I think months later, I saw a video by Patrick, from New Perspectives. He's got a YouTube channel, and he introduced this Forever Journal, I think it was called, concept of having a journal that every year over and over again. And that just blew my mind, and I thought, this is amazing. And his focus was on journaling. I come from a bullet journal background. That's what I used for a couple of years, and so for me it was really journaling, but it was logging things into my day. And that made a lot of sense for me. And I sort of expanded on it with monthly notes and quarterly notes and yearly note. But I love this idea of looking back at previous years in your current journal view. And that works really well in the framework. So I published it in September last year. I've been using it, maybe not in this complete form, for about 6 months before that. I think that I started with linking notes when it came out, which was, I think, about 2 years ago, a little bit less than 2 years ago. That's when I started, and then I built on top of that. And but I put it into a framework, you know, it sounds so big, but you know, I just wrote down the ideas behind it. And of course, while I was writing it, I was still developing it, and I'm still developing it. I'm still thinking about it all the time, and trying to make it simpler. I've talked to some people recently who use the framework, and some of them demanded even more structure, you know, and which is very interesting because I kind of kept it frameworky and loose, so that people can still adapt it to their own needs. But some people like to have even more structure and even more maybe guidelines on how to use certain elements or certain components of the framework. So I'm still working on it, and the community is also coming up with their own ideas and shortcuts and journal entry shortcut, like all sorts of ideas. Amazing.
So I think the process that he came up with was really interesting because he took just a simple process that he was doing and then turned it into something that was very powerful. So if you're enjoying today's stack, you can check out loads more stacks below. We've already got, I think, 4 or 5 out already. So if you want to explore other people's apps they use and the stories around them, then check it out in the link in the description. So the next thing I wanted to ask Matthias is more around the apps you use. Obviously we know Apple Notes is there, but what other apps are you using right now that you think are effective for your routine?
For note taking, obviously I'm using Apple Notes. That's where my framework is built in, and this is where my my personal knowledge lies. This is where it's all happening. This is where my planning happens. This is where I log my day. This is where I reflect on my day, where I reflect on my month, on my quarter, and my year. And I have it on every Apple device that I own. I mostly use it on my iPhone when I'm obviously, like, in the evenings on my iPhone, and when I'm out and about on my iPhone. During the day while I work, it's on my Mac. I don't do task management in Apple Notes. I use an app called Todoist. I think many people know it. I think my main selling feature, and I judge every to-do app on that, is whether I can forward emails to the task manager. The great thing about Todoist is that it AI generates the title and has a short description and also the original email in the task. And I just love that it goes into my inbox, and then I organize it into my projects, into my different folders and then the tasks or project folders in Todoist. So I think that's an amazing app. And also, like, the iPhone app is amazing. So I use that. My main web browser is Arc. Even though I'm a huge fan of Safari for its minimalistic look, its speed and everything, I do need, for my work, I need a lot of Chrome extensions. And for that, Arc works beautifully. It, you know, I can use them all in there. It's a great browser. I think my favorite feature in Arc is the different profiles. I have several businesses and projects that I'm working on, and I have a profile for each, so that when I log into my Gmail for one, I can, you know, I don't need to log in again in another one. So I really love Arc for that. And I'm also using it on my iPhone because it's synchronizing the open tabs and also the... So in my work as a designer, of course, I use the whole Adobe Creative Suite. I use Figma for web design and also presentation design sometimes, even though I use Keynote as my favorite tool. It's easy to use, and I love the animation part. And, like, when I present to people, when I present to clients, it's a fantastic software, I think. I use Webflow for programming and building prototypes for websites, and it's my go-to tool. I'm a visual designer, obviously, and even though I have some experience in HTML and CSS, this is a tool for me that works really well. Airtable comes in when we're talking about data. And so for my other business, the vegan cake business, I have many, many databases that are all based in Airtable. And some of them actually work really well with Webflow. So, for example, the database of our products is synchronized with Webflow and shows, like, so if we have a new product, listed in Airtable, and it gets automatically published in Webflow. So those, you know, Zapier, make.com, these kind of tools really, like, are amazing. I use Apple Freeform. This is, like, where I'm getting visually creative. Usually I use it on my iPad. This is where I draw, where I sketch, where I do flow diagrams with my Apple Pencil, and I just sort of rough sketches, or sometimes UX, UI, UX design, just very, very rough sketches. Sometimes I throw in some visuals, some photos from the web, just to create mood boards or stuff like this. And I think it's a great, again, another great free app from Apple, which I use on a weekly basis, I would say. Then, of course, like, again, my work as a designer, I use WriteFont. This is a font management software that can activate and deactivate fonts automatically when I need them in a specific document. I use that also on databases. And last but not least, Apple Passwords. Such a simple software, but it just works seamlessly across all devices. It's easy to use.
Okay, finally, obviously you're a busy guy. Like, doing the raw vegan bakery in the evening, all the way to being a graphic designer. That seems to be a lot of hats. We know what apps you use, but how do you use AI as part of your day to make that slightly easier?
AI is very interesting to me. I think it's very fascinating technology. And, of course, I've got the scary part in the back of my mind as well. And, think about, you know, what this means for my job as a designer, as a communications professional, and how long I will still be working in that job. But I don't really, I'm not sure whether I can say I have an AI workflow. I use Todoist for task management in one business. And I love that because when you forward emails to Todoist, it automatically AI generates a sort of a descriptive name and also a short description of the task or of the email, let's say this way. And it also, I think Todoist can suggest subtasks for that main task. And I love that. I think it's really helpful. I have used, actually pretty recently, I think last week, I was working on a project where I was adapting illustrations, and I had to create new illustrations, like a new series of illustrations. I used AI to help me analyze the existing illustrations, pick elements from those illustrations to incorporate in the new illustrations. I had a list of what illustrations I wanted to create, and it was just, I mean, anxiety wise, it's amazing. You know, I mean, like, I don't know if you've ever experienced this, but this blank piece of paper in front of you, and you know, having to think about, like, okay, where do I start? What is the first thing to do? I think AI can help, I mean, help me. Definitely in this project, it created a list, you know, with, you know, illustration number 15, you know, use the female character's body, you know, apply, you know, some additional clothes or a different hairstyle. And it really gave me first instructions. I followed about half of them only, but it was a great first step, and, you know, got rid of the anxiety. I think without it, it would have taken me twice as long to complete these, it was 6 illustrations. So that was amazing.
So I thought this was a fascinating chat. It's definitely clear that Matthias wears lots of different hats, and he created such a simple system that can be applied over the top of an app that is widely available on millions of people's phones. Sorry, Android users. But at the same time, it's a really interesting system that you can embrace, and I would highly recommend checking out in the link in the description. Please note as well, Apple Notes isn't the only app that you can use this with. You could probably apply this to other simple note-taking apps using Matthias's followed guides and resources, which you'll find on YouTube or in the link in the description. So thanks to Matthias for coming on today, and also for diving a little bit into his stack. A big thank you for you for stopping by, and feel free to share in the comments below a little bit more about what you learned from this stack. You can check out loads of stacks over on Toolfinder, and it's been great helping you to dive into this stack, and all the apps will be mentioned below as always. Thanks very much, and I'll see you very soon.